So with 3 minutes on the clock, SmartPress, to you, go.
As we all learn more about blockchain, we all strive to make change with it. But one key thing that our team identified at the start of this project is most people can't take the time to learn something really, really complex like C++ and building smart contracts and understanding the cryptography behind it and the use cases. But a lot of people have really good ideas that aren't that they can't implement themselves, so they would go to another person to implement it, a contractor, if you will. The thing about blockchain contractors are they are highly sought after. They're really hard to find, and they charge through the roof because of their services. It is so rare. So what we came up with was a solution for a fictional character named Jim. Jim is my friend, even though he's a fictional character, and he had a problem where he was trying to build a geo-mapping service that used a distributed system so anybody in the world could write to it sections of land that they'd like to remain protected. Maybe in their past, when they were children, they had really fond memories there, and they know that this land is really important to the local community and things such as this. So Jim wanted to do this, but he can't write a smart contract himself, and he can't afford to get a smart contract written for him because it would cost him upwards of $10,000 or high contractors that he probably can't even find. So we built a system that allows him to build his smart contracts in a graphical user interface. Yes, he can build his database without writing one piece of code and deploy it to the blockchain, all within our system. So you can change the number of columns, you can change the name, and you can change the types and names of the columns.
One minute warning.
So we've got here a north, south, east, west indicator and a reason for the reason that somebody would like to protect the land. We generate the database. It's generated, compiled, and uploaded to the blockchain within about 10 seconds. And now we can go to it at Jim's application that he's hooked up to our generated database. You can set the parameters that we just allowed inside our database. You can set your preservation reason that you'd like to preserve this area and the threatened species, and you can submit it. And so the reason that we did this without coming up with an idea that's exactly perfect to save the planet, what we thought was, let's empower the people who do have the educational knowledge to solve problems, to build their own solutions, without having to learn C++, without having to spend a lot of money, a lot of trial and error.
Ladies and gentlemen, a warm round of applause for SmartPress. SmartPress, if you want to grab your device and walk towards the middle of the stage to join your pitcher. Judges, 2 minutes of questions for you for Team SmartPress.
How does a non-technical person wrap their head around a smart contract through your user interface?
So through our interface, we basically declare it just like it would be a database. So a lot of people, I think, today would understand what a database does. You can send information to it, it can be stored, and you can delete and create things. With our database, users can control the rows that they own, and the system, there is a little bit of education that is needed, but I would argue that most people understand how generally a database works. You're sending data to it, you're sending it back, and it's stored in a distributed fashion. In the future, I see this as a kind of ubiquitous thing where we all assume things are going to be distributed in some fashion and we're going to have some control over our user data. So this idea might be a little novel now, but very soon I feel like this is going to scale to a lot of different people as they come up with ideas and realize that they can just deploy these things like they would a AWS server or something. So perhaps people like JavaScript developers who don't know the low-level tech skills of C++ can really come up with a lot of ideas and a lot of sustainable
45-second warning.
Are there any other questions?
No questions. All right, ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Team SmartPress. Our final prize winner Our grand prize winner and the final award for the EOS Hackathon Sydney goes to, by unanimous decision of the judging group team, SmartPress, come on down!
Our approach was, instead of coming up with solutions for the environment ourselves, the people who are helping the environment, who have the education to really see the issues and see how to solve them, we're giving them the ability to build their smart contract.
Our grand prize winning team, the winner of $100,000 and a trip to the grand finale, Team SmartPress.
Feels like a bit of a dream, and I'm still waiting to be pinched and woken up.